title of my talk and the solution of the second order PQ difference equation. Quantum calculus or Q calculus, known for limitless computation, has been an exciting field throughout its development, where important concepts and results have emerged across various branches of mathematics, including combinatorics, number theory, difference equations, and sequence spaces. Like F.H. Jackson Q difference equation, American Journal Mathematics, 1910. The other, R. Florentini, L. Willett, Q gamma and Q beta functions in quantum algebras, representation theory, Journal Computation Applied Mathematics, 1996. The others, Viktor Kac and Pacman, it is a book, 1902. The others is a book. The others, solving partial Q difference equations between reduced Q differential transform method. It is new, 1914. The others. Together with the studies on Q calculus, post-quantum calculus, which is called PQ calculus, was developed. The concept of PQ calculus was first examined in quantum algebras by Chakrapart and Janatkan in 1991. Their paper, EPQ oscillator realization of two-parameter quantum algebras, Journal of Physics, 1991. Later, PQ calculus theory was developed and many studies were carried. For instance, Sajjan proved the foundation theorem for PQ calculus and some PQ Taylor formulas for polynomials that write on the fundamental theorem of PQ calculus and some PQ Taylor formulas, Results Mathematics, 1918. The behavior of solutions of the PQ sense equations was investigated by Cambrisuk et al. Their paper published difference equations application 1918. The other researcher İlker Gençtürk also obtained some new existence results for solutions of boundary body problems in PQ calculus. His paper published Turkish Journal of Math 1992. Okay. The following two equations were studied in the continuous and discrete cases. First is x prime x2 prime t plus rho t x of t equal zero t in R real numbers and delta square x of t plus rho t x sigma t equal zero t in z. That is the set of integers respectively. The rho is the forward operator is the definite in R or Z. X sigma t equal x rho t equal x t plus one. If t is an integer, if t in real numbers, sigma t equal t. Among the many topics related to the study of equation one which has held the interest of mathematicians for every century is the study of the existence and location of the number of zeros of its solutions. In particular, the search of comparison type oscillation and non-oscillation criteria That is to say, necessary and or sufficient conditions on the functions for real world solutions of equation one, this to have or not to have an infinite numbers of zeros in the interval has long been studied in both the continuous and discrete settings. Especially the research on comparison type oscillatory and non-oscillatory cases of equations one has long been conducted for continuous and discrete cases. The fundamentals of this comparison type oscillation criteria for equation one were first developed by Sturm in 1836, established conditions such that rho of t greater than or equal rho zero greater than zero for oscillation and rho of t less than or equal zero for non-oscillations. In their paper published Journal Mathematics Pures Applications, 1836. However, the value of Sturm's study was not fully realized until papers by Boucher. Boucher has two papers. One of them is published Bulletin American Mathematical Society 1898. The others is published Bulletin American Mathematical Society 1901. Another well-known comparison kind criterion was proven by Nasser, and this condition implies oscillation for some epsilon positive, while this inequality implies non-oscillations. Their paper published Mathematical Analysis 1893. Later, Fitt and Hill provide a generalization of Nasser results and oscillation. Fitt published his paper Translation American Mathematical Society 1918. Hill published Trans American Mathematical Society 1948. For the study, we refer the following references: Wittner, Hartmann, Moore, Lee published about the topics. Much of what has been stated so far is based on two theorems, which we will briefly present below. The differential equation like this is oscillatory if and only if B greater one of four. The difference equations is similar like that, is oscillatory if and only if B greater than one of four. First equation is differential equation. A second is a difference equation, where x sigma t in one, sigma t equal one t. It is a identity operator. Second, sigma t equal t plus one. T is a integer number. Differential equation study by H.G. Lee, oscillation criteria for second order linear differential equation, Journal of Mathematical Analysis Applications, 1955. The others, difference equations studied by Bochner and Sacker, oscillation of second order nonlinear dynamic equations on time scales, recommended in Journal of Mathematics, 1904. And then Bohner and Onnel worked on the solution of the second order difference equations in Q calculus and provided some oscillation criteria. They definite these Q difference equations as like this, where T is a time scale, T Q upper n zero equal Q upper K. K is a natural numbers, not natural numbers with Q greater than one, and they also proved the following theorem. Borcher and Unal published their papers Journal of Physics 1905. They proved that the Q difference equations like that is oscillatory if and only if B greater than 1 over square root Q plus 1 square. If we take Q equal 1, this is reduced to 1 over 4. On the other hand, the fixed point theorem can be used to demonstrate the existence and the uniqueness of solutions of functional equations, integral equations, and difference equations. Like that paper, L. Brzezinski theorems about existence and uniqueness of solutions of semi-linear evaluation on local Cauchy problem, Journal of Mathematical Analysis Applications, 1991. And the others, B. Ahmad, S. K. Noturas, boundary problems for Q difference equations and equations with non-local and integral boundary conditions, mathematical models and application analysis, is published 1914. The others, E. G. Lakot, N. Hamiden, R. Kaldi, exist and uniqueness of solutions for a second order boundary work problems. Communication Faculty of Science of Ankara University is published 1913. It may be more beneficial to use non-local boundary conditions instead of classical initial conditions to better describe physical events. For example, Ahmed and Noturas investigated the existence and uniqueness of solutions of Q boundary volley problems with non-local and integral boundary conditions. B. Ahmad and Noturas papers, boundary volley problems for Q difference equations and equations with non-local and integral boundary conditions, mathematical model analysis, is published 1914. And others, Brzezinski, V. Lakshmi Katam, theorem about the existence and uniqueness of a solution of non-local abstract Cauchy problem in a Banach space is published, Applied Analysis, 1991. Motivated by the above results, we first studied the existence and uniqueness of solutions of the second order PQ difference equations by using the Banach fixed point theorem. We also investigate the oscillation of the solutions of the Euler Cauchy like PQ difference equation. Let us remember some essential concepts that are related to PQ calculus. Let X be any function such that X D subset or equal to R to R. The PQ derivative of the function is definite as like this. If you see there is not limits in this definition, and the PQ zero equal x prime zero in definition three t not equal zero p not equal q if t is zero, PQ DPQ x 0 equal x 0 provided that x differentiable at 0. The derivative operator DPQ is also linear. The PQ derivatives of product and quotients of x of t and y of t are given by like this. The product of quotients is not symmetrics. The PQ derivative is not subject to any general change rule, unlike the classical derivative. However, the change rule can be applied as a special case. Let mn be a constant. Consider the function y of x of y of t with y of t equal mt of n. In this case, the chain rule is obtained as follows. Equations 5. Okay. In the following theorem, we give two basic properties of the PQ integral. The first, suppose that x 0 t closed interval to r t greater than 0 is a continuous function. In this case, the following formula holds. Similar to the foundation of the integral. The other, suppose that a function x like the above functions. In this case, for t in 0 p square t, we have this equation. Okay. We use time scale. Time scale is a definite as an arbitrary non-empty closed subset of real numbers denoted by t. Like, for example, real numbers, integers, natural numbers, and non-negative integers are the main examples of time scales. Additionally, the forward jump operator is definite by like this. Sigma of t equal infimum s on in t s greater than t for all t in t. T squared to set. For more information, refer the readers the Kaç Victor Kaç book. Throughout this talk, we will consider the set T P prime and zero. It is it is Bohner and Inouye's works. The same is. In this case, the forward operator is sigma of t equal pt. Now we define the second order PQ difference equation as follows in equations 6. D square PQ x of t plus rho of t x sigma qt equal 0. Where for t in the same time scales t with p greater than 1. In these equations, the concept rho of t and dp xt are as follows. Rho of t b over qt sigma t. dpqt is x of t like this. Sigma is the forward jump operator. X sigma qt equal x pqt. The second order PQ derivative of the function x is as follows. There is some calculations. Also, it yields from 5 that the PQ derivative of x QT provides these equations. We will use equations 8 to rewrite equations 6 like this. In this case, equations 6 is transformed to equations 9, where E equal B P minus Q, B is in B with the Cartesians have equations 10. We note that equations 9 is similar to the Euler-Cauchy Q difference equations given in these references. Hence, we call these equations the Euler-Cauchy-like PQ difference equations. By using equations 5 and 7, we can rewrite equations 9 as follows. Equations 11, where there is rho and L identity. Also, the following connections are useful and can be easily controlled. Rho is equal in 13. Rho square minus L is definite 14. Equations 14. Now we can give the following lemma. Let rho and L be as in equations 12. Let gamma equal lambda up logarithma PQ. Also, let us assume that rho square minus L is definite by equations 11. If these equations satisfies, then the solution of the equation 9 is as below. Okay. Note that since lambda not equal zero, we can rewrite x lambda as follows. Like these equations, we can give the general equation solution of the equations 9 according to the value of L in the next theorem. Rho and L be as in equations 11. Let us assume that equations 10 exist. Equation 10 is. In this case, the general solution of equations 9 is obtained as follows. If L positive, then the solutions x of t holds like this. If L is equal to zero, then x of t is like this. If L negative, less than zero, something like that, the solutions of x of t has like this. Okay. In the above theorem, we give the solutions of the equations 10. If L positive, L negative, L is zero, L is negative, then the solutions are like this. Okay. We also generalize the general solutions in theorem 4 to PQ calculus. That is, theorem 6 is reduced to the Q version of tends to 1. Now we give some basic definition of concept of oscillations. We recall that the solutions X of t of equations 6 has a generalized zero at t if x of t equals zero. Now we say that x of t has a generalized zero in the interval q t sigma t if x q t x sigma t is negative. Okay. We this is a time sequence time scale q t okay q t jump operator sigma q t this is a şu x q t if like this graphics the point of x is a zero of x of t. Okay. I cannot okay. We also say that equations 6 is non-conjugate on the interval AB. If there is no non-trivial solution of equations 6 with two or more generalized zeros in AB. We say that equation 6 is non-oscillatory on zeta closed infinite interval if there exists a point such that this equation is non-conjugate on AB closed interval for every a less than b. In other cases, we mean that equations 6 is oscillatory on zeta closed and infinite interval. We also can define that an axis x of t solutions of equation 6 is non-oscillatory if x q t dot x sigma t positive on this interval. On the contrary, we mean that the solutions x of t is oscillatory on this interval. Okay. In this definition, we state two and third are as in 1929. However, one and for our generalization of the situation in the Q calculus. One and four is a Q calculus. Two condition and three condition is real numbers. Real numbers. Now we can give the PQ calculus version of Sturm tip separation theorem. Let's we first remind some conclusions. It is easy to see that one solution of equation 6 is non or oscillatory. If and only if every solution of 6 is non or oscillatory, non-oscillatory or oscillatory. To prove this, let us assume that x of t is a non-oscillatory solution of equation 6. In this case, it is x of q t and multiply dot x sigma t positive. From definition of oscillatory, let y of t be any solution of equation 6. Also, let x of t and y of t be linearly independent. Thus, this differentiation not equal zero. Then y of t over x of t is exactly monotone and hence has a single signum. Thus these equations false and ultimately positive. And y qt y sigma t positive. This means that y of t is also non-oscillatory. That is one solution of equations 6 is oscillatory. Only if every solution of 6 is oscillatory, the others holds. Next, we can give the theorem about oscillation. The main theorem, the PQ difference equations. These equations is oscillatory if and only if b greater than 1 over square p and square q square root p and square root q over square. Theorem 12 is related to theorem 2 for p times 1. In addition, we observe that theorem 12 is related to the continuous case in theorem 1. When we take the limits as q goes to 1, equal p, and note that the constant, this constant becomes 1 over 4. Now we can give the PQ version of Nester theorem, PQ Nester theorem. If these inequalities false, then 6 is non-oscillatory on this time scale. The others, if these inequalities false, then 6 is oscillatory on that time scale. If rho of t, okay. Rho of t equal b over qt sigma of t. We substitute these equations. This will be b, and b less than this constant, and this will be b greater than this constant. This is reduced to Sturm theorem. Okay. Now we will give the Banach fixed point theorem applied to this boundary value problem. We have this boundary problem. T in this interval and boundary conditions x of 0 is like this and x of t like this. X denote the Banach space of all continuous real functions with the norm and k x from x to r be any bounded function. Let eta in x such that eta of t equal minus phi t x sigma q t. In this case, wonder problem reduce to this 17 boundary problem. 17 is equivalent to the PQ integral equation x of t like this. Okay. And we now introduce an operator f self mapping of x. F x of t like this. Phi is any we choose eta s of phi eta also phi phi function phi function and phi function it is similar f of t. By lemma 16, the necessary and sufficient condition to have a solution of the problem 16 is that the operator f has a fixed point. For simplicity, we take the constant PC like this. The well-known Banach contraction principle is given as follows. Let X be a Banach space and as self-mapping of X. If there exists a constant p 0 closed 1 open interval such that this inequality satisfies for all x y in x, then s has a unique fixed point. The following theorem is based on the Banach fixed point theorem. Let phi be a continuous function such that a1, a2, a3 holds. In this case, the problem 16 has a unique solutions. A1 about an phi function, a2 about an k function, and the others this inequality must be should be. If we take phi function is equal like this in equation 16, we obtain the existence and uniqueness of solutions of the equations 16. Example, consider the following PQ boundary problem. We choose these equations instead of phi. Boundary conditions like this. And A1, A2, and A3 satisfies. And then from theorem, above theorem, the problem has 20 has a unique solutions. Okay. We give a open problem to study the oscillation of equations like this in 17 by taking phi functions different from equations 6. Thank you very much for your attention. This is published is a recent paper on the solution of the second order PQ differential equation with an application to fixed point theory. Ames Mathematics 1994 article in press. Okay. We have these references. I mentioned about of this. Okay. Thank you very much.